Assalamu alaikum and welcome you all once again in the lecture of the series of the biostates. Today is the lecture number 4 and part C. In the today lecture, in the lecture number 4, we will go to learn about the measures of the variability. In the measures of the variability, we will go to learn how the data are the variance, how the data are the spreadness, how much the variability is present inside the data set. So for the measurement of the data set, variability of the data set, we have the 4 method. The first method, which is very easiest way to measure the variability of the data, is called the range. And the second one method, after the range, we will go to measure the mid-range of the data set. And the third one, the third method, we measure the variability of the data by the variance and standard deviations. And the fourth method is called the coefficient of the variations. Now see, here I put the two data set. In the one data set, when I measured the mean of the both of the data set, it will come up after the calculation. The mean of the both the data set is 10, 10. The mean of this data set, data number 1 and data number 2, both of the mean of the both of the data set is come up with the 10 after the calculations. So the mean is in the same. If we calculate the mean of the data set, it will come up the same. But if you look at the both the data set, the variation is present, the huge variability present among the both of the data set. If you will go to calculate the range of the both the data set, so for the data number 1, the formula for the range is highest value minus lowest value. The highest value of the data number 1 is 15 and the lowest value is 5. It will come up with the 10. The range of the first data set is 10. And the range of data number 2, the highest value is 19 and the lowest value is 1. Then the range has been come up with 18. Now see, as I told you earlier, even though the mean of the both of the data set is equal 10, but I told you, just you look roughly on the both of the data set, a lot of the variation is present among the both of the data set. How we will go to measure this variability? How we will go to say the data is both data are not dissimilar? The variation is present between the two data set. So the easiest method is the range. By the range, we calculated the range of the first data set is come up with the 10, the value of the 10, and then we calculated the range of the second data set, we come up with the answer of the 18. Now in the 10 and the 18, a huge difference. We can say the data number 2 is more variation, as the more spreadness is present in the data number 2 as compared to the data number 1. Now we will go here. The third data is here. In the third data, we have the 10 patients. The age of the 10 patient is here. Age of the 10 patients here. Now the highest value of this data set, of this age of the 10 patient is 552, and the lowest age of the patient in this data set is 34. If you go minus it, then it will come up with the 18. Okay. The 18 is the range of the third data set. Even though we can say also the range, the variation, a lot of the variation is present in the data number 3 as well. Now we will go to calculate the mid range of the data set. This is the range, this is the first method by which we can measure the variation in the data set. Now the second method is the mid range. For the mid range, formula for the mid range is lowest value plus highest value, and we will go to divide by the 2. Now in the first data set, the lowest value is 5 and the highest value is 15, and divide by the 2. So it will come up 20 divided by 2, it's a 10. The mid range of first data set, after the calculation through the formula, it will come up with the 10. Now the second, the mid range for the second data, the lowest value is 1 and the highest value was, the highest value is 19. So it will be the sum of the 20 divided by 20 divided by 2, it come up the 10. So the mid range of the both data set of the 1 and the 2, it come up with the 10, like the same of the mean of the both of the data set. Now in the third data, the lowest value is 34 and the highest value is 52, 8 and divided by 2. So it will come up 6, 5 plus 3 is 8, 86 divided by 2, it will come up with the 43. The 43 is the bit range of the third data set. So here we learned the easiest way to calculate the variability of the data by the range and the mid range, and this is the clear the concept how you will go to measure the variability of the data by these two methods, by the range and the mid range, by which we can measure the which data is more in which data is more variable, or which in which data is the more variance is present. By the two, these two easiest ways, the range and the mid range, we can calculate it. So we will stop over here. Then the variance and coefficient variance we will go to learn in the second lecture. Thank you.